In this video, we're going to talk about what the effects would be of omitting an adjusting entry on the financial statements. In a previous video, I taught you these 10 year-end adjusting entries. In this video, I want to look at three of them and analyze what the effects would be on the financial statements if we were to neglect making these. Here we have the year-end adjustment for supplies, wherein we're supposed to have debited supplies expense and credited supplies, but we neglected to do it. And so we're going to consider what the effects will be on the income statement and the balance sheet. You see the two formulas on the right. The top formula is the income statement, and the next one is the balance sheet. We are missing a debit to supplies expense, so I'm going to create a T account for the category expense. And we're missing a credit to the supplies account, which is an asset, so I'm going to make a T account for the asset category. Let's remember that expenses have a debit balance. The normal balance of expenses is debit. That means the plus sign is on the debit side. The balance of expense accounts is on the debit side. The normal balance of asset accounts is also debit. The balance of assets is on the debit side. We are missing a debit to the expenses. So I'm just going to type right in there, missing a debit. And in the case of the assets, we are missing a credit. Okay, now let's start thinking. If we're missing a debit in the expense account, which is supposed to have all debits in it, then the balance is going to be understated. The effect of expenses being understated is shown in that red arrow on the income statement. Now let's look at the asset category. If we're missing a credit to an asset account, and asset accounts are supposed to have a debit balance, then the balance will be too large because we neglected to subtract something. This error carries over to the balance sheet. Assets are overstated, as indicated by the red arrow. Now let's look at the income statement. If expenses are understated, net income will be overstated. Because if you subtract a number that is too small, your answer will be too large. The error in net income, or the overstatement of net income, will be transferred to retained earnings in the closing process. So owner's equity will be overstated also. Let's do another example. Here is an adjusting entry that we neglected to make. I'm going to explain this more quickly than I did in the first example. The next thing we would do is make two T accounts. The unearned revenue account is a liability account, and liabilities have credit balances. That means the plus sign is on the credit side, and the balance is on the credit side. We're missing a debit to the unearned revenue. Now let's look at the revenue account. Revenue has a credit balance. The plus sign is on the credit side. We are missing a credit number in the revenue account. Look at the unearned revenue account, the liability. If you're missing a debit in an account that is supposed to have a credit balance, then you're not subtracting something that you should have, and the balance will be too high or overstated. That error will transfer to the balance sheet as liabilities being overstated. Next, let's look at the revenue account. The revenue account is missing a credit that should have been added in that total. So the total is missing a number, and therefore the balance is understated. That understatement of revenue transfers to the income statement. Now let's look at the income statement. If revenues are too small or understated, and you subtract the correct expenses, well, your answer is still going to be understated. Net income is understated. Net income will be transferred to retained earnings at the end of the year in the closing process. So that understatement of net income leads to an understatement of owner's equity. Here's our third example. Here is the adjusting entry that we neglected to make. Let's make T accounts for these two neglected line items. Interest receivable is an asset, so assets have the plus sign on the debit side. That means the normal balance of an asset is debit. Interest revenue is a revenue account. It has a credit balance. We're missing a credit in that account. Okay, let's start analyzing. The interest receivable is missing a debit, and therefore the balance is understated. Interest receivable is an asset, therefore assets are understated on the balance sheet. Now let's look at the interest revenue account. We're missing a credit in this account, and therefore the balance is missing a number and it is understated. The interest revenue understatement is transferred to the income statement. Revenues are understated. Revenue is understated, and if you start with a number that is understated and then subtract the correct number of expenses, your answer will still be understated. Net income is closed to retained earnings at the end of the year. So this error, this understatement of net income, will lead to an understatement of owner's equity.